Today I'm going to talk to you about our new program. It's a Master's of Science in Geospatial Technology that's offered at the University of Washington, Tacoma, and Savannah is one of our great students in the program this year. So as we all know, the world is very complex, and GIS can help us make sense of the world. Increasingly, more and more people are gaining access to GIS tools, but they may not think of them in those terms. We think of them as ubiquitous computing devices or mobile phones. So this is bringing more access to GIS tools to a more diverse population. So this means the general public, decision makers, traditional GIS analysts, as well as computer scientists. And so in our program, we're trying to train our students to work and build tools for all of these different actors. So in the Masters of Geospatial Technologies, we're training students to not only use traditional GIS, but also develop mobile applications and use other technologies such as action cameras and other technologies. So it's a one-year program. It's really, really quick. My colleague Jim Thatcher and I are the only two that teach. Every student takes two courses per quarter, and then in the spring and summer, based on what they've learned in the courses, they're then to build their own capstone project. So in these courses, we do formal training for mobile and web, customizing GIS, but we also do informal training to train the students to learn on their own, because the technology changes so rapidly, the students are going to need to continually learn on their own. The students are also gain expertise in every step of the GIS process, from data collection, analysis, to information visualization and dissemination. We're also incorporating cyber GIS to accommodate these big data sets. So cyber GIS is taking GIS to these unstructured, unwieldy, large data sets and applying GIS concepts to them. So we're taking this body of knowledge, these accepted GIS concepts, integrating them with these new cyber GIS principles, and training the students to incorporate these into the real world in their job, into their current positions. And this is kind of a modernization of Marble's 1997 pyramid of students. So you start out with a basic user, then they gain more knowledge and become a GIS technician, and then they become the computer scientist GIS expert, or cyber GIS expert. But my colleague Jim and I were increasingly uncomfortable with this hierarchy. We see it more as a cycle. Everyone has a really important role to play in a robust and functional cyber GIS relationship. So we have the people designing the visualizations for data input and output. We have the back-end people building the databases. We have the GIS analysts. And then we also have the topic and domain experts. And we all are important. And we have students with all of these backgrounds and expertise coming into these programs. Increasingly, GIS isn't looking like the traditional desktop anymore. This is social media data scraped. And then this is structure for motion software that's basically photogrammetry on steroids. And so this has created a 3D model from unmanned aerial vehicle. The students have lab assignments every week. They build an online portfolio to demonstrate their skills and what they've learned for future employers. And so here are two screenshots from some of their online portfolios. And then this is an example from a student's capstone project last year, where he built a mobile application to show the user the fishing regulations based on where they are in that moment, that season. And this student was then hired by the state of Washington Labor Department to be a consultant with mobile design. This is another example of two capstone projects. One was using aerial photos captured from an unmanned vehicle to show acute change after a landslide incident. Another was using it to do infrastructural inspections to prevent falls that happen with those. And we have students that are, they want to remain in their positions in government as GIS analysts, and we train them to train their colleagues and what's possible. Some want to go on and do PhDs, while others want to do other things. So we're not teaching traditional GIS, we're teaching our students to train others, to teach others what's possible with geospatial technology, from decision makers to the ones collecting the important data. And we're also training them to work together with other members of a team that have other skill sets, so we can all work together to build this robust and highly functional GIS system. And this is a picture of our very first cohort that graduated last year. So thank you.